Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Erin Phalo. We do have some breaking news for you. Police in Franklin now say they have arrested a woman in connection to this suspicious fire that destroyed a multifamily home on School Street. The flames broke out just before 7 o'clock last night. No one was hurt, but a family of four was displaced. Police will not comment yet on the charges. They haven't released the woman's name yet, but we hope to learn more this morning when she's arraigned in Franklin Circuit Court. Berlin police say a local man admitted to them that he shot and killed his own dog. They say the owner told them that the dog became dangerous and bit a young child on a number of occasions. Police say it's not clear why the owner did not go to a vet or a shelter, but he was sad about the death and is being cooperative. Investigators are now researching statutes governing animal cruelty and euthanasia to determine if what he did was legal. A Concord woman is recovering after a boating crash on Lake Winnipesaukee. Investigators say 22-year-old Kelsey DeHood was driving a jet ski in Paugus Bay in Laconia yesterday afternoon when she collided with a fishing boat. The driver of the boat quickly helped her out of the water. The circumstances surrounding the crash are still under investigation. Merrimack police are investigating a case of vandalism at the skate park on Agera Drive. They say that someone spray-painted graffiti on the ramps, knocked over barrels of trash, and lit a small fire in a porta-potty. The vandalism happened sometime between Friday and Monday. Anyone with information is urged to call Merrimack police. A mosquito pool in Manchester has tested positive for the West Nile virus. This is the first positive test so far this year. Health officials are urging people to use bug spray and wear protective clothing like long sleeves and pants when they're outside. Some people who have the virus never show any symptoms, while others think they may have the flu. The threat will not end until the first hard frost. And that's it for your morning update. We'll have more news on the air for you today at noon.